Today, the Taze community is made up of over 100 brothers, Catholics and from various Protestant backgrounds, coming from around 30 nations. By its very existence, the community is a parable of community that wants its life to be a sign of reconciliation between divided Christians and between separated peoples. Singing is one of the most essential elements of worship. Short songs, repeated again and again, give it a meditative character. Using just a few words, they express a basic reality of faith, quickly grasped by the mind. As the words are sung over many times, this reality gradually penetrates the whole being. Meditative singing thus becomes a way of listening to God. It allows everyone to take part in a time of prayer together and to remain together in attentive waiting on God. Silence makes us ready for a new meeting with God. In silence, God's word can reach the hidden corners of our hearts. In silence, it proves to be sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing until it divides soul from spirit. In silence, we stop hiding before God, and the light of Christ can reach and heal and transform even what we are ashamed of. Unlike hymn singing, these chants are not designed to be constantly sung by every member of the assembly. At times, your voice might, or even should, be still while your spirit sings on in silence for a while, feeding on the words and hearing the voice of God speaking deep into the soul. After a while, your voice may rejoin the chant.
In the Lord I'll be ever thankful, in the Lord I will rejoice. Look to God, do not be afraid, lift up your voices, the Lord is near. Lift up your voices, the Lord is near. In the Lord I'll be ever thankful, in the Lord I will rejoice. Look to God, do not be afraid, lift up your voices, the Lord is near, lift up your voices, the Lord is near. In the Lord I'll be ever thankful, in the Lord I will rejoice, but to God, do not be afraid, lift up your voices, the Lord is near, lift up your voices, the Lord is near. In the Lord I'll be ever thankful, in the Lord I will rejoice. Look to God, do not be afraid, lift up your voices, the Lord is near. Lift up your voices, the Lord is near. In the Lord I'll be ever thankful, in the Lord I will rejoice. Look to God, do not be afraid, lift up your voices, the Lord is near. Lift up your voices, the Lord is near. In the Lord I'll be ever thankful, in the Lord I will rejoice. Look to God, do not be afraid, lift up your voices, the Lord is near. Lift up your voices, the Lord is near. In the Lord I'll be ever thankful, in the Lord I will rejoice. Look to God, do not be afraid, lift up your voices, the Lord is near. Lift up your voices, the Lord is near.
Lord God, you are the source of everlasting light. Your Son, our beloved Lord Jesus, was presented in the temple 40 days after his birth. He was recognized by Simeon and Anna and welcomed as the promised Messiah. May we, like them, behold the glory of the Lord Jesus. Grant that we may stand before you with hearts cleansed by your forgiving love. May we serve you all our days and make your name known as we worship you as our Lord. So, may we come by your grace to eternal life. Amen. Thus says the Lord God, Lo, I am sending my messenger to prepare the way before me. And suddenly there will come to the temple the Lord whom you seek, and the messenger of the covenant whom you desire. Yes, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. But who will endure the day of his coming? And who can stand when he appears? For he is like the refiner's fire, or like the fuller's lye. He will sit refining and purifying silver, and he will purify the sons of Levi, refining them like gold or like silver, that they may offer due sacrifice to the Lord. Then the sacrifice of Judah and Jerusalem will please the Lord, as in the days of old, as in years gone by. A short time of quiet to contemplate these words.
Waiting for the Lord.
When the days were completed for their purification, according to the law of Moses, Mary and Joseph took Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, just as it is written in the law of the Lord. Every male that opens the womb shall be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer the sacrifice of a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons, in accordance with the dictate in the law of the Lord. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, awaiting the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Christ of the Lord. He came in the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to perform the custom of the law in regard to him, he took him into his arms and blessed God, saying, "Now, Master, you may let your servant go in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you prepared in the sight of all the peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and glory for your people Israel." A significant time of quiet to contemplate these words.
Oh, Lord, the light of my life, my God.
A shorter time of quiet during which you may like to light a candle, in token that you are committed to follow the light of Christ for this year and to be a light for others. A significant time of quiet as we focus on our candle and allow God to shine his light upon and within us and speak to us in response to our prayers. As the child Jesus was presented in the temple, so we now present our needs before the throne of God.
The response to each petition is Alleluia.
Alleluia.
That the church may proclaim effectively the light of Christ to all. To all nations, and bring to faith those who do not yet believe in him, we pray to the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
For government officials, that they may come to the temple of the Lord frequently to seek wisdom from his word and grace from his sacraments, we pray to the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
That we may look upon the unborn as children who belong to God and who deserve the same respect and protection as every other human being. We pray to the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
That those afflicted by poverty, war, or sickness may experience the light of the Savior born to heal all nations. We pray to the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
That all who have died may behold face to face the Savior who came for them. We pray to the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Lord, your light continues to shine in our world and in our lives. Make us faithful to that light and enable us to lead all people to your Son, Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
As we close together, let's sing together, Christ be our light.
Longing for love, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see.
Yeah.